Hi there. Joel Colander here with Rock Island Auction Company, taking a look at one of the items in our 2016 December Premier Firearms Auction. Now, this item will be instantly recognizable to any Quentin Tarantino fans out there. I'm referring, of course, to the hand firing mechanism Mark II, or as it's more popularly known, the Sedgley Glove Gun, or as its patent names it, the Fist Gun. And no matter how you slice it, it sounds pretty awesome. These guns were given their shining moment in Quentin Tarantino's alternate history movie, Inglourious Basterds, where two of the rebel group used them to begin a massacre on a theater full of top-ranking Nazi officials and Adolf Hitler himself. Because of their unusual nature, these guns are thought to have a place in the world of espionage and subterfuge, when in reality, the patent holder, a Mr. Haight, I think I'm pronouncing that correctly, had the common soldier in mind. Worried about sneak attacks and hand-to-hand combat, he thought giving a soldier a weapon that wouldn't be required to be grabbed or manipulated in any such way would save valuable time and save lives. In other words, concealability was a plus, but speed of deployment was paramount. The Sedgley Glove Gun works exactly how you think it would, and how you saw earlier in the movie clip, with one notable exception. You, of course, put it on, make a fist, which puts this plunger in front of the knuckles, meaning it's going to be the first thing that contacts anything that's punched. Depressing that, of course, fires the round, and of course making a fist keeps your knuckles and fingers behind any sort of muzzle blast. In the movie, they do depict him cocking the mechanism. Now, I don't know if that's a bit of Hollywood magic, and I don't have another Sedgley Glove Gun to compare it to, for example, but this particular one, every time you push the plunger, a firing pin comes out right there. And it returns every time you push the gun. So a little bit different, but ultimately, it all works the same way. Punch, bang, one dead opponent. Doing all this successfully would fire a 38 caliber round into your target at contact distance, but it could have been worse. The original patents called for the gun to be chambered for 410 shells. Users of either round would be grateful for a leather pad mounted to the inside of the glove to protect the user from the screws and mounting hardware that attach the firing mechanism to the glove. Well, gang, we said today's video would be a short one, so for more interesting firearms and amazing history, tune in to Rock Island Auction Company's YouTube channel for more videos just like this. Thanks for watching, and keep your powder dry.